This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Florida I, ˈflɒrɪdə, Spanish for Land of Flowers, is a state located in the southeastern region of the United States. The state is bordered to the west by the Gulf of Mexico, to the north by Alabama and Georgia, to the east by the Atlantic Ocean, and to the south by the Straits of Florida and Cuba. Florida is the 22nd most extensive, the 3rd most populous, and the 8th most densely populated of the United States. Jacksonville is the most populous city in Florida, and the largest city by area in the contiguous United States. The Miami metropolitan area is the 8th largest metropolitan area in the United States. Tallahassee is the state capital. A peninsula between the Gulf of Mexico, the Atlantic Ocean, and the Straits of Florida, it has the longest coastline in the contiguous United States, approximately 1,350 miles (2,170). Colonial powers. Before it gained statehood in the United States in 1845, it was a principal location of the Seminole Wars against the Native Americans, and racial segregation after the American Civil War. Today, Florida is distinctive for its large Cuban expatriate community and high population growth, as well as for its increasing environmental issues. The state's economy relies mainly on tourism, agriculture, and transportation, which developed in the late 19th century. Florida is also renowned for amusement parks, orange crops, the Kennedy Space Center, and as a popular destination for retirees. Florida culture is a reflection of influences and multiple inheritance. Native American, European American, Hispanic and Latino, and African American heritages can be found in the architecture and cuisine. Florida has attracted many writers such as Marjorie Kinnan Rawlings, Ernest Hemingway and Tennessee Williams, and continues to attract celebrities and athletes. It is internationally known for golf, tennis, auto racing and water sports. Contents. 1. History. 11. European arrival. 12. Joining the United States. Indian removal. 13. Slavery, war, and disenfranchisement. 14. 20th century growth. 2. Geography. 21. Climate. 22. Fauna. 23. Flora. 24. Environmental issues. 25. Geology. 3. Demographics. 31. Population. 32. Municipalities and metropolitan areas. 33. Racial and ethnic makeup. 34. Ancestry groups. 35. Languages. 36. Religion. 4. Governance. 41. Elections. History. 411. Elections of 2000 to present. 42. Statutes. 43. Law enforcement. 5. Economy. 51. Personal income. 52. Real estate. 53. Tourism. 54. Agriculture and fishing. 55. Industry. 56. Government. 6. Health. 7. Architecture. 8. Education. 81. Primary and secondary education. 82. Universities. 9. Transportation. 91. Highways. 92. Airports. 93. Intercity rail. 94. Public transit. 10. Sports. 11. Sister states. 12. See also. 13. References. 14. Bibliography. 15. External links. History. Main article, History of Florida by the 16th century, the earliest time for which there is a historical record. Major Native American groups included the Apalachee of the Florida Panhandle, the Timucua of northern and central Florida, the Ice of the central Atlantic coast, the Tacubaga of the Tampa Bay area, the Calusa of southwest Florida, and the Tequesta of the southeastern coast. European arrival. Main article, Spanish Florida. Map of Florida, likely based on the expeditions of Hernando de Soto 1539-1543. St. Augustine is the oldest city in Florida, established in 1565. The Spanish Floridan color scheme of red and white is repeated throughout downtown. The Castillo de San Marcos, originally white with red corners, its design reflects the colors and shapes of the Cross of Burgundy and the subsequent flag of Florida. Florida was the first part of the continental United States to be visited and settled by Europeans. The earliest known European explorers came with the Spanish conquistador Juan Ponce de León. Ponce de León spotted and landed on the peninsula on April 2, 1513. He named the region La Florida, Land of Flowers. The story that he was searching for the Fountain of Youth is a myth. In May 1539, conquistador Hernando de Soto skirted the coast of Florida, searching for a deep harbor to land. He described seeing a thick wall of red mangroves spread mile after mile, some reaching as high as 70 feet 21. Oldest European settlement in the continental U.S. and establishing the first generation of Floridanos and the government of Florida. Spain maintained tenuous control over the region by converting the local tribes to Christianity. The area of Spanish Florida diminished with the establishment of English settlements to the north and French claims to the west. The English attacked St. Augustine, burning the city and its cathedral to the ground several times. Spain built the Castillo de San Marcos in 1672 and Fort Matanzas in 1742 to defend Florida's capital city from attacks, and to maintain its strategic position in the defense of the Captaincy General of Cuba and the Spanish West Indies. Florida attracted numerous Africans and African Americans from adjacent British colonies who sought freedom from slavery in 1738. Governor Manuel de Montiano established Fort Gracia Real de Santa Teresa de Mos near St. Augustine, a fortified town for escaped slaves to whom Montiano granted citizenship and freedom in return for their service in the Florida militia, and which became the first free black settlement legally sanctioned in North America in 1763. Spain traded Florida to the Kingdom of Great Britain for control of Havana, Cuba, which had been captured by the British during the Seven Years' War. It was part of a large expansion of British territory following their victory in the Seven Years' War. A large portion of the Spanish Floridano population left, taking along most of the remaining indigenous population to Cuba. The British soon constructed the King's Road connecting St. Augustine to Georgia. The road crossed the St. John's River at a narrow point, which the Seminole called Waka Palatka and the British named Cow Ford, both names ostensibly reflecting the fact that cattle were brought across the river there. The British divided and consolidated the Florida provinces Las Floridas into East Florida and West Florida, a division the Spanish government kept after the brief British period. The British government gave land grants to officers and soldiers who had fought in the French and Indian War in order to encourage settlement, in order to induce settlers to move to Florida. Reports of its natural wealth were published in England. A large number of British settlers who were energetic and of good character moved to Florida, mostly coming from South Carolina, Georgia, and England. There was also a group of settlers who came from the colony of Bermuda. This would be the first permanent English-speaking population in what is now Duval County, Baker County, St. John's County, and Nassau County. The British built good public roads and introduced the cultivation of sugar cane, indigo, and fruits, as well the export of lumber. As a result of these initiatives, northeastern Florida prospered economically in a way it never did under Spanish rule. Furthermore, the British governors were directed to call general assemblies as soon as possible in order to make laws for the Floridas, and in the meantime they were, with the advice of councils, to establish courts. This would be the first introduction of much of the English-derived legal system which Florida still has today, including trial by jury. Habeas corpus and county-based government. Neither East Florida nor West Florida would send any representatives to Philadelphia to draft the Declaration of Independence. Florida would remain a loyalist stronghold for the duration of the American Revolution. Spain regained both East and West Florida after Britain's defeat in the American Revolution and the subsequent Treaty of Versailles in 1783, and continued the provincial divisions until 1821, joining the United States. Indian removal. See also, Florida Territory and Seminole War's defense of Florida's northern border with the United States was minor during the Second Spanish period. The region became a haven for escaped slaves and a base for Indian attacks against U.S. territories, and the U.S. pressed Spain for reform. Americans of English descent and Americans of Scots-Irish descent began moving into northern Florida from the backwoods of Georgia and South Carolina. Though technically not allowed by the Spanish authorities, the Spanish were never able to effectively police the border region, and the backwoods settlers from the United States would continue to migrate into Florida unchecked. These migrants, mixing with the already present British settlers who had remained in Florida since the British period, would be the progenitors of the population known as Florida Crackers. These American settlers established a permanent foothold in the area and ignored Spanish officials. The British settlers who had remained also resented Spanish rule, leading to a rebellion in 1810 and the establishment for 90 days of the so-called Free and Independent Republic of West Florida on September 23 after meetings beginning in June. Rebels overcame the Spanish garrison at Baton Rouge, now in Louisiana, and unfurled the flag of the new republic, a single white star on a blue field. This flag would later become known as the Bonnie Blue Flag. In 1810, parts of West Florida were annexed by proclamation of President James Madison, who claimed the region as part of the Louisiana Purchase. These parts were incorporated into the newly formed territory of Orleans. The U.S. annexed the Mobile District of West Florida to the Mississippi Territory in 1812. Spain continued to dispute the area, though the United States gradually increased the area it occupied. Seminole Indians based in East Florida began raiding Georgia settlements, and offering havens for runaway slaves. The United States Army led increasingly frequent incursions into Spanish territory, including the 1817-1818 campaign against the Seminole Indians by Andrew Jackson that became known as the First Seminole War. The United States now effectively controlled East Florida. Control was necessary, according to Secretary of State John Quincy Adams, because Florida had become a derelict open to the occupancy of every enemy, civilized or savage, of the United States, and serving no other earthly purpose than as a post of annoyance to them. Florida had become a burden to Spain, which could not afford to send settlers or garrisons. Madrid therefore decided to cede the territory to the United States through the Adams-Onis Treaty, which took effect in 1821. President James Monroe was authorized on March 3, 1821 to take possession of East Florida and West Florida for the United States and provide for initial governance. Andrew Jackson, on behalf of the U.S. federal government, served as a military commissioner with the powers of governor of the newly acquired territory for a brief period. On March 30, 1822, the U.S. Congress merged East Florida and part of West Florida into the Florida Territory. A contemporaneous depiction of the New River Massacre in 1836. By the early 1800s, Indian removal was a significant issue throughout the southeastern U.S. and also in Florida. In 1830, the U.S. Congress passed the Indian Removal Act, and as settlement increased, pressure grew on the United States government to remove the Indians from Florida. Seminoles harbored runaway blacks, known as the Black Seminoles, and clashes between whites and Indians grew with the influx of new settlers. In 1832, the Treaty of Payne's Landing promised to the Seminoles lands west of the Mississippi River if they agreed to leave Florida. Many Seminole left at this time. Some Seminoles remained, and the U.S. Army arrived in Florida, leading to the Second Seminole War 1835-42. Following the war, approximately 3,000 Seminole and 800 Black Seminole were removed to Indian Territory. A few hundred Seminole remained in Florida in the Everglades. A cracker cowboy, 19th century. On March 3, 1845, Florida became the 27th state to join the United States of America. The state was admitted as a slave state and ceased to be a sanctuary for runaway slaves. Initially, its population grew slowly as European American settlers continued to encroach on Seminole lands, and the United States intervened to move the remaining Seminoles to the west. The Third Seminole War 1855-58 resulted in the forced removal of most of the remaining Seminoles. Although hundreds of Seminole Indians remained in the Everglades, slavery, war, and disenfranchisement. Further information: Florida in the American Civil War. The Battle of Olustee. During the American Civil War, 1864, American settlers began to establish cotton plantations in northern Florida, which required numerous laborers, which they supplied by buying slaves in the domestic market. By 1860, Florida had only 140,424 people, of whom 44% were enslaved. There were fewer than 1,000 free African Americans before the American Civil War. In January 1861, nearly all delegates in the Florida legislature approved an ordinance of secession, declaring Florida to be a sovereign and independent nation, an apparent reassertion to the preamble in Florida's Constitution of 1838, in which Florida agreed with Congress to be a free and independent state. Although not directly related to the issue of slavery, the ordinance declared Florida's secession from the Union, allowing it to become one of the founding members of the Confederate States, a looser Union of States. The Confederal Union received little help from Florida. The 15,000 men it offered were generally sent elsewhere. The largest engagements in the state were the Battle of Olustee, on February 20, 1864, and the Battle of Natural Bridge, on March 6, 1865. Both were Confederate victories. The war ended in 1865. Following the American Civil War, Florida's congressional representation was restored on June 25, 1868, albeit forcefully after radical Reconstruction and the installation of unelected government officials under the final authority of federal military commanders. After the Reconstruction period ended in 1876, white Democrats regained power in the state legislature. In 1885, they created a new constitution, followed by statutes through 1889 that disfranchised most blacks and many poor whites. rights until the mid-20th century. Florida was the least populous southern state in 1900. Its population was only 528,542, of whom nearly 44% were African American, the same proportion as before the Civil War. The boll weevil devastated cotton crops. 40,000 blacks, roughly one-fifth of their 1900 population, left the state in the Great Migration. They left due to lynchings and racial violence, and for better opportunities. Disfranchisement for most African Americans in the state persisted until the civil rights movement of the 1960s gained federal legislation in 1965 to enforce protection of their constitutional suffrage. 20th century growth. Historically, Florida's economy was based upon agricultural products such as cattle farming, sugarcane, citrus, tomatoes, and strawberries. Economic prosperity in the 1920s stimulated tourism to Florida, and related development of hotels and resort communities combined with its sudden elevation in profile was the Florida land boom of the 1920s, which brought a brief period of intense land development, devastating hurricanes in 1926 and 1928, followed by the Great Depression, brought that period to a halt. Florida's economy did not fully recover until the military buildup for World War II. The climate, tempered by the growing availability of air conditioning, and low cost of living made the state a haven. Migration from the Rust Belt and the Northeast sharply increased Florida's population after the war. In recent decades, more migrants have come for the jobs in a developing economy. With a population of more than 18 million according to the 2010 census, Florida is the most populous state in the southeastern United States, and the fourth most populous in the United States. Key West Historic District. Downtown Jacksonville houses many of the city's iconic and historic structures. The Florida House on Capitol Hill, or Embassy of Florida, in D.C. Historic Ybor City in Tampa. The Downtown Miami Historic District has some of the oldest buildings in Miami. Geography. A topographic map of Florida. Köppen. Climate. Types of Florida. Main article, Geography of Florida. See also, List of counties in Florida and List of Florida state parks. Much of the state of Florida is situated on a peninsula between the Gulf of Mexico, the Atlantic Ocean, and the Straits of Florida, spanning two time zones. It extends to the northwest into a panhandle, extending along the northern Gulf of Mexico. It is bordered on the north by the states of Georgia and Alabama, and on the west, at the end of the panhandle, by Alabama. It is the only state that borders both the Atlantic Ocean and Gulf of Mexico. Florida is west of the Bahamas and 90 miles 140. The climate of Florida is tempered somewhat by the fact that no part of the state is distant from the ocean north of Lake Okeechobee. The prevalent climate is humid subtropical Köppen, CFA, while areas south of the lake including the Florida Keys have a true tropical climate Köppen. Mean high temperatures for late July are primarily in the low 90s Fahrenheit 32 to 34. The farthest northern regions frost is more common than snow, occurring sometimes in the panhandle. The USDA plant hardiness zones for the state range from zone 8A no colder than 10. November-December. Jacksonville 65 42nds 68 45th 74 50th 79 55th 86 63rds 90 70th 92 73rds 91 73rds 87 69th 80 61st 74 51st 67 44th Miami 76 60th 78 62nds 80 65ths 83 68ths 87 73rds 89 76ths 91 77ths 91 77ths 89 76ths 86 73rds 82 68ths 78 63rds Orlando 71 49ths 74 52nds 78 56ths 83 60ths 88 66ths 91 72nds 92 74ths 92 74ths 90 73rds 85 66ths 78 59ths 73 52nds Pensacola 61 43rds 64 46ths 70 51st 76 58ths 84 66ths 89 72nds 90 74ths 90 74ths 87 70ths 80 60ths 70 50ths 63 45ths Tallahassee 64 39ths 68 42nds 74 47ths 80 52nds 87 62nds 91 70ths 92 72nds 92 72nds 89 68ths 82 57ths 73 48ths 66 41sts Tampa 70 51sts 73 54ths 77 58ths 81 62nds 88/69, 97/4, 97/5, 91/76, 89/74, 85/67, 78/60, 72/54 of a degree Celsius. January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December. Jacksonville, 18/6, 27/23, 26/13, 30/17, 32/21, 33/23, 31/21, 27/16, 23/11, 19/7. Miami, 24/16, 26/17, 27/18, 28/20, 31/23, 32/24, 33/25, 33/25, 32/24, 28/20, 26/17. Orlando, 22/9, 23/11, 26/13, 28/16, 31/19, 33/22, 33/23, 32/23, 29/19, 26/15, 23/11. Pensacola, 16/6, 18/8, 21/11, 24/14, 29/19, 32/23, 32/23, 31/21, 27/16, 21/10. 17/7, Tallahassee, 18 quarters, 26/23, 27/11, 31/17, 33/22, 33/22, 28/14, 23/22, 33/22, 38/14, 25/14. Tampa, 21/11, 23/12, 25/14. 27/17, 31/21, 32/23, 32/24, 33/24, 32/23, 29/19, 26/16, 22/12. Florida's nickname is the Sunshine State, but severe weather is a common occurrence in the state. Central Florida is known as the lightning capital of the United States, as it experiences more lightning strikes than anywhere else in the U.S. Florida has one of the highest average precipitation levels of any state, in large part because afternoon thunderstorms are common in much of the state from late spring until early autumn. A narrow eastern part of the state, including Orlando and Jacksonville, receives between 2,400 and 2,800 hours of sunshine annually. The rest of the state, including Miami, receives between 2,800 and 3,200 hours annually. Florida leads the United States in tornadoes per area when including waterspouts, but they do not typically reach the intensity of those in the Midwest and Great Plains. Hail often accompanies the most severe thunderstorms. Hurricanes pose a severe threat each year during the June 1 to November 30 hurricane season, particularly from August to October. Florida is the most hurricane-prone state, with subtropical or tropical water on a lengthy coastline of the Category 4 or higher storms that have struck the United States. 83% have either hit Florida or Texas from 1851 to 2006. Florida was struck by 114 hurricanes, 37 of them major, Category 3 and above. It is rare for a hurricane season to pass without any impact in the state by at least a tropical storm. Citation needed. Florida was the site of what was then the costliest weather disaster in U.S. history, Hurricane Andrew, which caused more than $25 billion in damage when it struck in August 1992. It held that distinction until 2005, when Hurricane Katrina surpassed it. Hurricane Wilma. Snow is uncommon in Florida, but has occurred in every major Florida city at least once. Winter in Miami. Miami's tropical climate makes it a top tourist destination in the winter. Fauna. Further information: List of mammals of Florida and snakes of Florida. An alligator in the Florida Everglades. Florida is host to many types of wildlife, including marine mammals, bottlenose dolphin, short-finned pilot whale, North Atlantic right whale, West Indian manatee mammals, Florida panther, northern river otter, mink, eastern cottontail rabbit, marsh rabbit, raccoon, striped skunk, squirrel, white-tailed deer, key deer, bobcats, gray fox, coyote, wild boar, Florida black bear, nine-banded armadillos, Virginia opossum reptiles, eastern diamondback and pygmy rattlesnakes, gopher tortoise, green and leatherback sea turtles, and eastern indigo snake. In 2012, there were about 1 million American alligators and 1,500 crocodiles. Birds: peregrine falcon, bald eagle, northern caracara, snail kite, osprey, white and brown pelicans, sea gulls, whooping and sandhill cranes, roseate spoonbill, Florida scrub jay state endemic, and others. One subspecies of wild turkey, Meleagris gallopavo, namely subspecies Osceola, is found only in Florida. The state is a wintering location for many species of eastern North American birds as a result of climate change. There have been small numbers of several new species normally native to cooler areas to the north, snowy owls, snow buntings, harlequin ducks, and razorbills. These have been seen in the northern part of the state. Invertebrates, carpenter ants, termites, American cockroach, Africanized bees, the Miami blue butterfly, and the grizzled mantis. The only known calving area for the northern right whale is off the coast of Florida and Georgia. The native bear population has risen from a historic low of 300 in the 1970s, to 3,000 in 2011 since their accidental importation from South America into North America in the 1930s. The red imported fire ant population has increased its territorial range to include most of the southern United States, including Florida. They are more aggressive than most native ant species and have a painful sting. A number of non-native snakes and lizards have been released in the wild in 2010. The state created a hunting season for Burmese and Indian pythons, African rock pythons, green anacondas, and Nile monitor lizards. Green iguanas have also established a firm population in the southern part of the state. There are about 500,000 feral pigs in Florida. Key deer in the lower Florida Keys. The Florida scrub jay is found only in Florida. West Indian manatee. Florida panther, native of South Florida. Leatherback sea turtle. Whooping crane. Flora. There are about 3,000 different types of wildflowers in Florida. This is the third most diverse state in the Union, behind California and Texas, both larger states on the east coast of the state. Mangroves have normally dominated the coast from Cocoa Beach southward. Salt marshes from St. Augustine northward. From St. Augustine south to Cocoa Beach, the coast fluctuates between the two, depending on the annual weather conditions. Everglades National Park in southern Florida. Bahia Honda in the Florida Keys. Ocala National Forest in central and northern Florida. Timucuan Ecological and Historic Preserve in northeast Florida. Environmental issues. The beaches of Key Biscayne in Miami. Main article, Environment of Florida. Florida is a low per capita energy user. It is estimated that approximately 4% of energy in the state is generated through renewable resources. Florida's energy production is 6% of the nation's total energy output, while total production of pollutants is lower, with figures of 56% for nitrogen oxide, 51% for carbon dioxide, and 35% for sulfur dioxide. All potable water resources have been controlled by the state government through five regional water authorities since 1972. Red tide has been an issue on the southwest coast of Florida, as well as other areas. While there has been a great deal of conjecture over the cause of the toxic algae bloom, there is no evidence that it is being caused by pollution or that there has been an increase in the duration or frequency of red tides. The Florida panther is close to extinction. A record 23 were killed in 2009, predominantly by automobile collisions, leaving about 100 individuals in the wild. The Center for Biological Diversity and others have therefore called for a special protected area for the panther to be established. Manatees are also dying at a rate higher than their reproduction. Much of Florida has an elevation of less than 12 feet 37. Areas. Therefore, it is susceptible to rising sea levels associated with global warming. The Atlantic beaches that are vital to the state's economy are being washed out to sea due to rising sea levels caused by climate change. The Miami Beach area, close to the continental shelf, is running out of accessible offshore sand reserves. Geology. Main article, Geology of Florida. The Florida Peninsula is a porous plateau of karst limestone sitting atop bedrock known as the Florida Platform. The largest deposits of potash in the United States are found in Florida. Extended systems of underwater caves, sinkholes, and springs are found throughout the state and supply most of the water used by residents. The limestone is topped with sandy soils deposited as ancient beaches over millions of years as global sea levels rose and fell during the last glacial period. Lower sea levels and a drier climate revealed a much wider peninsula, largely savanna. The Everglades, an enormously wide, slow-flowing river, encompasses the southern tip of the peninsula. Sinkhole damage claims on property in the state exceeded a total of $2 billion from 2006 through 2010. Florida is tied for last place as having the fewest earthquakes of any U.S. state. Earthquakes are rare because Florida is not located near any tectonic plate boundaries. Demographics. Main article, Demographics of Florida. See also, Culture of Florida. Florida's population density. Population. Historical population. Census. Pop. Percent. Plus or minus. 1830 34,730, 1840 54,477, 569%, 1850 87,445, 605%. 1860 140,424 606% 1870 187,748 337% 1880 269,493 435% 1890 391,422 452% 1900 528,542 350% 1910 752,619 424%. 1920 968,470 287% 1930 1,468,211 516% 1940 1,897,414 292% 1950 2,771,305 461% 1960 4,951,560 787% 1970 6,789,443 371%. 1980 9,746,324 436% 1990 12,937,926 327% 2015 1,982,378 235% 2010 18,801,310 176% S 2015 20,271,272 78% sources 1910-2010-2015 estimate the United States Census Bureau estimates that the population of Florida was 20,271,272 on July 1, 2015, a 782% increase since the 2010 United States Census. The population of Florida in the 2010 Census was 18,801,310. Florida was the seventh fastest growing state in the U.S. in the 12-month period ending July 1, 2012. In 2010, the center of population of Florida was located between Fort Meade and Frostproof. The center of population has moved less than 5 miles 8.